story for Children's Church at Christ Church Lancaster. It's a very odd story and quite fragile. A bit like a parable. Parables can break if you're not ready for them. And this box is old. Older, perhaps, than you or me. Are old too. I wonder if there could be a parable inside. The box is gold. Gold is valuable. Parables are valuable. Perhaps there too could be a parable inside. And the box also has a lid on it. Sometimes parables are like doors that are shut. Even when you are ready, you can't get inside them. I don't know why, it just happens. But don't give up. Keep coming back, and one day, the door will open. And this box looks a bit like a present. You know, there might be a parable inside because you were given a present before you were even born. The parables were given to us. And even if you don't know what a parable is, it is still yours. I wonder if there is a parable inside. Let's have a look and see. Desert. Maybe some dirt. Maybe something to make things with. There's no green at all. It's all brown. There's no blue anywhere. It feels scratchy. But it's hard to know what this could be if there is only brown. Let's see if there's anything else in the box that can help. Crack. But it is going from this place to this place. There's more. Look at this. Oh, it's dark. Let's see if they help us make sense of the parable. Hmm. There was once a man who did such amazing things and said such wonderful things that people heard him speaking about all sorts of things, and sometimes they asked him questions. And one day a person asked him what the most important thing in life is. The person he asked said, "You already know." "That's true, I do. It is to love God and to love people just as if they are your neighbours." But the person paused for a while and thought. He then asked another question. "But who is my neighbour?" So the person he then asked told them this parable. There was once someone who went from Jerusalem down to Jericho. And as he went on his way, he was attacked by robbers. They hurt him, and they took everything that he had. Left him beside the side of the road, half dead. Now, there was also a great priest of the temple going down from Jerusalem to Jericho. As he went along the road, he came to the place where the person who had been hurt and had had everything taken from him and was left by the side of the road. But when the priest came to him, the priest went by on the other side and went on his way. There was also someone who worked at the temple, who went from Jerusalem down to Jericho. He was one of the people who helped the priests. He took care of the temple and helped with music. He was called a Levite, and when the Levites came to the place where the person who had been hurt had everything taken from him and had been left by the side of the road half dead, he too went to the other side and he went on his way. There was also a person who went on the road who did not live in Jerusalem. He was visiting from a country called Samaria. And the people in Samaria did not like the people in Jerusalem, and the people in Jerusalem did not like the people from Samaria. And when the stranger came to where the person who had been hurt had everything taken from him, and had been left by the side of the road, half dead, the stranger went to him. The stranger put medicine on the places where the person was hurt. He gave him his coat to put on. Then him on his donkey. The stranger even stayed with him all the way through the night. And in the morning, he gave the innkeeper enough money for him to stay there until he was well. Now I wonder, who is the neighbour? Person who was hurt, had everything taken from him, and was left by the side of the road, half dead. I wonder if it could be this one. Or this one. Who is the neighbour to this one now? It's not easy, is it? Could it be this one? Or this one? This one. Or this one. Now I wonder what would happen if the people in this parable were women and not men. The person finding the injured traveller were a child. There is lots to wonder about in this story. Every time you see it, you might wonder something different. As we tell this story, sometimes the lid opens, sometimes it stays shut. As you continue to wonder about this parable, you might like to continue to tell the story for yourself, to make something or draw something. You wonder about what this story is.